Hello there, and as usual, I'm Aaron from Last Stand Gamers, and welcome. We are now back on the server, and since it's been a week or so since the last little update, I wanted to show you just how bases are coming along. Now, we were at the Jaff outpost before, so you can see the Jaff outpost itself is expanded. They've got more ships undergo. They've started the work on a few of these defensive turrets just to deter attackers. We've been through the majority of the base, and some of the buildings that were exposed in the past have now started new construction. So for instance, inside here, they've got themselves a nice little hangar with a selection of different ships, everything in that blue Jaff color. For some reason, it reminds me of Jaffa Cakes. I don't know why, but you can see they've got a few ships on the go. Now, the DRF did attack them the other day, and it didn't really go too well for the DRF. They managed to launch ships and tackle them pretty damn fast. They have also changed up their drilling system. They decided to go with an actual drilling ship so they can be a little bit more effective, but you can see the power of that there. And everything is bristling with turrets because this world is damn inhospitable. So we've got one of the largest ships down here. Everyone is gearing up towards something that could possibly be a war or an end of server event. So going across here, they've also started to try and inhabit the old mine. Some of the old tunnels that already existed, they're building across or expanding out through it. Just what I wanted to see with the sort of monuments and whatnot, but you can see they've built themselves some tunnel access, and it looks like they were going to start extending it up there as well. So that's all we've got on the Jaff outpost, apart from a few new ships, the finishing of the rover, and another strange vessel over there. They've done quite a bit in, well, there's also a grinder pit down here. Is this the grinder pit? Ah, they've moved it. So this time they've actually got a little chute there that they can roll things down into that grinder pit. Very nice, very smart little idea. And they've got the control panel room up there as well. Anyway, let's pop over to another base and see how they're doing. So now that we're out at another outpost, something that I've seen a lot of players attempting to do as well is build rovers. Now, as you can see here, this player looks like he's already tipped this rover over in doing some sort of activity. Some damage has occurred, but he's trying to get it rolled back over. My recommendation would be a gyroscope, but building a rover in this rocky sort of terrain is going to be extremely difficult as it is, but it's a very quite nice design. You've got some turrets on the top, you've got all the resource things in there so they can travel around. The only issue is, as we step inside here, it has rolled onto its side. And I know a lot of players ask for admin support with stuff like this, but this is something that you've got to solve yourself. This is an engineering task. The game is about engineering. So when players come to me and say, can you help flip my rover over and stuff, the moderators on this server are simply going to say no, because that is another really cool engineering task that you're going to have to solve. Maybe it is as simple as flipping it over with gyroscopes, or maybe you need to contact another faction and see if they'll help you out. Anyway, let's continue moving on from some of these smaller bases. Of course, this particular outpost is on the surface. It's easy to spot, and in a lot of cases, something like this can get taken out pretty damn fast. So it's working for him at the moment due to the remote location, but let's keep going. So as we come over to the Henrington Castle, as I like to call it, we've got a player here who's attempted to turn it into an outpost. Of course, he's been attacked, and you can see this by the various different attachments that he's been left around. There's a few parts smoking. People, of course, come across this location, they mark it down, and they'll come back and forth. So it's not always the best idea to build these landmarks. But you can see some of the locations have been shot up, hacked. Probably passing drones have actually had a go at this place as well. But it's got the start of a really nice outpost. It's just something that'll have to be. So this is welcome to AM at your service always. All request non full cargo proceeding. Okay, so we've got ourselves the basics of a really nice castle outpost there. But the player himself has vacated by the look of it. He's just left his destroyed base and tried to move somewhere that will probably be a little bit safer for him or their faction. So as we continue to explore, we come across outpost after outpost. Now, a lot of these outposts are literally next door to each other. And the surprising thing is, it means that there's going to be a lot of conflict between neighbors. And neighbors either have to make friends or they soon become enemies. So we've got ourselves a little mining pod in here. We've got ourselves all the supplies, a basic and functional survival base. This is one on the surface. It's a little bit better protected. It's got a limited number of turrets, so it isn't a super threat. So what you would call to the DRF. So the DRF are not going to prioritize a little outpost like this, but if it starts gunning up, getting some ships together, then the DRF might pay this guy a visit, and poor Henno here might have some trouble on his hands, but his base is coming along quite nicely. Let's continue on. So we're heading to another evil mountain layer, or maybe they're good guys, I don't know. But once again, we've got ourselves a massive wind production, and due to this server having very limited uranium resources, or in fact, one faction being able to control them, due to them catching the territory, a lot of the other factions are going to have to deal with solar or other renewable power sources, such as hydrogen, other things like that. And you can see we've got a lovely little outpost going on inside here. We've got some basic projector-type buildings, equipment, we've got ourselves a mining or a welding ship in fact there, and the refinery is optimized to best performance. So if we just dip through the terrain here, you can have a quick look at the actual shell they've made. A very basic hangar, but there is a lot exposed on the outside. Now there is a ship missing from this outpost that I did want to have a look at, so we might have to catch it in the action. Let's continue having a look. Now you're probably wondering what happened to that massive underground bunker base that we looked at in the last video. Well, this is it right here. Now this thing is gearing up for war. This faction, not giving any names away at the minute, but you'll probably see them pop up on the hood. They are gearing up for some serious war. We've also got the orb type pod that I was searching for before. Now this thing looks damn scary. It's not got a lot of firepower directed in each of the angles, but it's got one of the turrets on either side, so this could be a particular problem for a would-be attacker. Hang on, there's another orb. Look at these. These look so scary, especially when they come over the terrain. We'll have to see how they do in a fight, though. So the outpost is actually extended and moved around quite a lot. So you can see we've got separate hangar bays now going on. The connection pipe work is being done behind the scenes here. And as we enter back into the bunker that we were once familiar with, you can see we've got fighters being docked once again. These guys can build very quickly. They've changed up their printing procedure after some recommendations from the admins. And this is something I'd recommend for you guys. Have a static welder pit and then have a ship that rolls off or can hold the projector rather than having it on pistons. It's so much more functional and it stops so many production issues. But it looks like they've got another strange craft underway there, hidden in some sort of box perhaps. So back out through the entrance, and in this case it's completely open. They don't usually leave the entrance open like that. We've got the big ship on the deck, as well as a little bit of a platform for docking various vessels on the outside. These guys are gearing up. They've not got a load of equipment, but that big ship certainly does look pretty scary with all them fighters aboard it. Anyway, let's continue going through different bases on the server. So we've now headed over to the USR's base. Now, we've had a look at this base in the past, and these guys like to take a pounding from a few other factions, but they do give it back in return. So let's have a quick look. It looks like we've got one of the ships either crashed to the ground or parked there. And as we enter over the top area, this is a new sort of ship. I haven't seen too much. It's took a little bit of damage, but oh, there is some gearing up definitely going on here. They've got this really cool, narrow, thin-looking ship, and this is their massive excavation. I think they thought it'd be cool to build the ships inside the hangar, and then realised that they had to mine the way out to get things going. So we've got miners, we've got docking ports down here, and like we saw before, we've got the underground system. Not changed too much, but all these voxels are going to protect ships and things that they hide down here. We've also got some smaller, strange looking, maybe even Russian looking fighters. They're very cool indeed. And then we've got the main hangar bay up here at the front, where they usually use this little rover vehicle to weld things up from that rotor there, and it works quite effectively until they decide to reverse too far and go into the grinder pit. But that hasn't happened too much. Let's keep going through the bases. It's nice to see a lot of changes happen. They've still got this side hangar door. Yeah, that's all sealed up. Everything's ready to go. It's a really nice big base in the hull of that big bit of rock there. The ships themselves look a little bit damaged. They must have been doing a bit of fighting with them, but they could probably deal out quite a bit of damage. That one's even hydrogen equipped, so that could possibly get into space. But it's very interesting to see what USR are doing here. Let's keep looking through the bases though. So let's return over to the HAL pit. Now outside, as we just load everything for a second, there's quite a bit to load in. We've got one of the mining type ships that was, I think this was used in one of the missions off in another area, but how we managed to capture it and bring it back. They've got a really scary outer defense here. You can see they've got the logos, the different decorations on the vehicle. This faction has it together in a lot of ways. There is a lot of them though, and they did manage to claim the uranium pit at the start, so they've had quite a bit of an advantage. There's been some attacks going on here. You can tell some of the turrets are damaged, sparking. There is some repairs that need to be made up here to keep this base functional, and a lot of people have been attempting warhead attacks on this outpost. You can see the decoy pods at various different intervals protecting the pit, but let's go down. So as we drop into the pit, we've got the inner ring of turret defences holding some protection. And then as we drop further down, we've got lighter and lighter defence levels until we get to the first connector. Now, the first connector itself, that ship's still parked. That's not been moved. You can see we've got the drill there, drilling out more hangar bays for ships to actually park in, and down the massive tube itself leads us down to the pit. Now, we saw some of these ships launched the other day, and it looked absolutely beautiful as they intercepted the drones. You'll have to check out that video if you haven't, but some more hangar bays are coming together. They've got a lot of ships going on here. We've got the Marshmallow there. We've got another one of these. These actually have rotor-based machine guns on the front here, and these do a serious amount of damage. The DRF didn't know what hit them when they came to be attacked by them. So as we continue a little bit further down, we've got more of these ships docked up in these various areas, and we've got the entrance to the base. There's more construction taking place here. They're making it a little bit more finalized, and they've also got steps up there in case you lose hydrogen. There's also some weird disco lights in here. Maybe there is a rave going on that I don't know about, or maybe I've not been invited to it. So we're going to go back into the Howe bunker. Now, they hated it when I looked at it last time, but we're going to do it again. The whole point of this server is me exploring people's creations. So this place is just a scary trap of death. And here we are. This is where they plan all their missions. They've got a lovely cage up there for Frank Pigeon. Oh god, I don't even want to look at that. Let's look away. Okay, so we've got the HAL logo on the decks there. We've got ourselves various different other rooms. This must be the new processing hub. So they've really spent some time and fixed this place up and caused some disco mayhem in here. They've got a bar going on. This is everything. This is a real base. This is the stuff you've got. But I guess when you control uranium on the planet, then this is something that you can do. Oh, and they've got a to-do list as well. Very nice. Okay, a bit graphic as well. So that was the HAL's outpost. That's their update on it. A very nice little outpost. The only issue I see with it is a lot of factions really want this uranium. I know it's been slowly being degraded by impacts and missiles and things that have been dropped down here. There's always a bloody wreck down the bottom of the pit as well. Someone always tries it on and ends up getting shot to death. So that was HAL's outpost. We'll do one last look and see what we're going to find. Now, most of the other outposts, I believe, are going to be quite small. But let's have a look. So to bring this one to a conclusion, the server is going amazingly. Of course, we have the odd issues here and there. The main one being connection issues at the moment that we're getting every now and then. But we're working on ways to solve it. There's some great outposts, some great designs there. And more importantly, the debates and the involvement of the community in this server has been fantastic. So I'd like to thank you guys all for watching. Sorry I've not featured everyone's single outpost or particular ship, but maybe next time. Who never knows? Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.